Hey everybody, Trevor Noah here. And today, I'm in Seattle, Washington at the Fred Hutchinson Cancer Center. I'm going to be meeting with psychologist Dr. Jonathan Bricker, who is the principal investigator for QuitBot, which is an AI-powered chatbot that aims to help people quit smoking using emotional support. The big question is, how can we help people combat addiction by using large language models?
You can't find answers without asking the right questions. This is The Prompt with me, Trevor Noah.
Dr. Bricker.
Trevor, how are you?
Pleasure.
Pleasure, please. Thank you so much. We always ask questions about AI, how we can use it, what it can be used for, what it can change. The work you're doing is some of the most fun, in my honest opinion. Talk me through what you're working on. What is the problem and what are we trying to solve?
Well, what I focus on in my lab is prevention of cancer. There are 8 million people in the world who die every single year from tobacco use. I mean, nicotine is more addictive than cocaine, than heroin.
Wow.
And yet there are not enough healthcare providers that can help them to quit smoking.
A lot of what keeps people smoking is the psychological connection between the cigarette oftentimes and how they think it's affecting them. They think it's helping them de-stress. Where would a chatbot step into this?
What we're trying to do is to mimic the kind of connection and relationship and advice and help that they would get from a clinician, but have it in their pocket. Have it available to them 24/7 to give them expert coaching that can guide them along the way. And it actually has turned out to be a very daunting task. How do you design a computer program that can develop a relationship with a person who wants to quit smoking?
I struggle to understand how a chatbot helps somebody to quit when everything else failed. How does this happen? What is the conversation? And what have you discovered in this? Like, what are the tools that actually help people quit smoking?
We created a program that is a series of 32 different conversations about quitting smoking. The conversations begin with learning about why you'd like to quit, knowing about when you have cravings, what sort of feelings you have, like loneliness or sadness or anger or stress that trigger you to smoke. And then learning about the kinds of situations that throw you off that may make you want to smoke. And so it learns about these things, and then it comes back to you later and reminds you, remember why you're quitting. This is for your family, or this is for your relationships, or this is to take care of your body. And then it gives you specific tools on how to deal with those triggering situations. And we've learned a lot about how to use natural language processing to be able to do it. It was very, very hard to get this program to understand what people meant when they asked a question. We've overcome a lot of those challenges now.
Obviously, this program is focusing on smoking. Many of the same triggers will be found across different addictions. Could we end up seeing a world where QuitBot is able to apply itself to any addiction that people are trying to get over?
What we've created in QuitBot is a habit change platform. And anytime someone is trying to change a habit, you want to find out, what are your motivations? What's driving you to change? What are your goals? What are your barriers? What are your triggers? And then how do you help people stay in the maintenance phase after they've met their goals?
Right.
And so we think that we can adapt QuitBot to help people with these other addictive behaviors, to help people with food cravings if they're trying to lose weight. So we see a very broad applicability to the QuitBot program.
It's a fascinating journey that you're on, and I wish you the best of luck because I think we're all going to benefit from it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for the time.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it.